The continent of Africa is a complex story of beauty and variety. As well as hardships. And then there are many in Africa who still hold on to the darkness of traditional religions. However, many in Africa are searching for the truth, and Christian Literature for Africa has the truth. As well as a call to share the truth with our African brothers and sisters. In 1991, CLA was born in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Out of a desire at Edna Lochner's heart, a retired missionary from Africa, to supply Africa with Christian literature. After outgrowing four different locations for CLA, it was apparent that a more permanent place was needed to effectively continue on with the ministry. To the glory of God, a permanent structure with offices was dedicated in October 2004. Located in this building are rooms for processing, packing, as well as sending of books, Bibles, and literature to many African countries. How does CLA acquire books and literature for distribution? Often by word of mouth. A bi-monthly newsletter tells of various timely needs. Types of books Africa is requesting, financial needs, and prayer requests, as well as stories and testimonies of those whose lives have been touched by this ministry. What is the process from receiving the materials to shipping the boxes? Some books need cleaned up papers and personal information. Items are categorized and placed on shelves. Boxes are assembled, inventoried, and items are packed into boxes. Pack boxes are stacked according to their destination. Loading and unloading the truck is a huge job. But as the saying goes, many hands make light work. So where are these boxes being shipped to? You have heard it said, it takes a village to raise a child. So it is with CLA. It takes a whole lot of people to keep the ministry going and growing. We thank the Lord for the opportunity to reach the second largest continent on the globe, having a population of over 1 billion people and more than 50% of the population under the age of 25. With the life-changing gospel, as well as contributing to the teaching and training of pastors and laymen. Thank you. You are a vital part of a ministry that has eternal rewards. Whoever is generous to the poor lends to the Lord, and he will repay him for his deed. What is done today in the Lord's name and for the Lord's sake will last for eternity. And so it is that we pray this prayer. Lord, give us the wisdom and understanding, as well as the helping hands to continue to minister to the spiritually hungry and thirsty of Africa.